Chica.
Thank you for coming today. My name is Dr. Sarah Elliott, MBA, CPA, JD, and PhD. I am the Vice President of the Human Resources Department for the Coca-Cola Company. I've been working there for approximately 10 years. I have a good friend who works at LSU and they invited me here today, so I'm happy to be here talking to students in the business college, future CEOs. It's going to be great. So today we're going to talk about how to act at a business luncheon. I have been to countless business lunches and seen how they can go very, very wrong, but I've also been to many that are very successful. So if you just pay attention today, take notes, you will never fail or embarrass yourself at a business luncheon. So specifically, we're going to cover these 8 topics today: what to wear, arriving early, cell phone usage, your posture, ordering the appropriate drinks, being respectful, gearing the conversation in the right direction, as well as the bill. So our first topic we're going to cover today is what to wear at a business luncheon. So it takes only about 15 seconds for someone to form an impression of you. So how you present yourself is very, very critical. And if that impression is bad in those first 15 seconds, it can take years to change that impression. So today I'm going to teach you what is proper attire and then what is completely unacceptable attire. So as you look this way on the screen, I'm going to show you just the other. So our second topic we're going to cover is arriving early or on time. A good rule of thumb is always to be there about 10 to 15 minutes before your meeting is going to start. Always allow for traffic, any unforeseen vehicle, you know, issues. You never want to be late because you were stuck in traffic. That's also really bad.
What the fuck? Let's go!
Car, checking Instagram or Snapchat, you know, waiting to walk in at the right time than being really late, because being late, running in, that can be seen as rude. Also, it affects that first impression of you when you arrive to a business luncheon, especially when you're trying to impress future employers.
If we keep doing what we're doing, like communicating and all that, we'll be nice if you can join us.
Hey, excuse me. Hey, you going to a business meeting?
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah, the answer help is nice to meet you.
Drew Duffer.
Too bad, yeah. They got you where they want you. There's a better life.
Hey, how you doing today, guys? I'd like to introduce y'all to Drew Duffer.
Dr. Julius Andre. This is Tommy. All right, let's get the meeting started.
So our third topic we're covering is cell phones. So, you know, isn't it so annoying when you're somewhere and someone's phone starts ringing in the middle of a presentation? Yeah, that's really embarrassing.
As we were saying, like, next year we're planning big things for us, big things.
So always make sure your phone is off, silent. You know, if that starts ringing in a business luncheon, no bueno. Like you right now on your phone, like, stop. That's so disrespectful. Can't you see? That's just so disrespectful. Can't handle that. I wouldn't hire you. So our fourth topic of conversation is posture. This is very, very important. You want to be sitting up straight, elbows off the table. Obviously, do not put your feet on the table. That is number one, do not do that. It shows that you're actively paying attention, that you're listening, and that you want to actually be where you are when you're sitting up straight and you're just engaged in the conversation. It makes a world of difference. So our fifth topic of conversation is ordering the appropriate drinks. So I know you all are in college right now, but a business luncheon is not a pregame. So you do not need to order a round of shots for your business peers. You do not need to whip out a flask and pour it into your water or into your drink.
How y'all doing today?
Good. Yeah, how about you?
Okay. Any drinks to start off?
I must start off with a bottle of water.
Yeah, I could say.
Can I get 4 shots of whiskey?
We don't serve alcohol.
Oh, that's all right, guys. I got my own.
If you want to be on the safe side, just always order a soft drink, tea, water, always a good go-to.
How are y'all doing today?
Good, how about you?
Would y'all like any drinks to start off?
Water all around, right?
Yeah, that sounds good.
All right.
So just a side note here, it may be okay to have an alcoholic beverage at a business luncheon. It just depends on your host and if they are drinking or not. And it really is okay if it's beer or wine or something that's not a round of shots. You know, you get me.
So number 6 is respect. Being respectful to the waiter, the waitress.
Dude, I am so hungry. Hey, hey, boy. Hey, hey. I'm trying to order. Y'all ready?
Can I get the baby back ribs with a side of fries, please?
All right, got it. And you?
Can I get the quiche?
Ooh, I don't think we have any.
Respecting those people who are serving you and who are eating at the table with you. That's just a good rule of thumb, you know.
Oh yeah, sure. What would you like?
I'm gonna get the baby back ribs with a side of fries, please.
Okay. And you
guys a key?
I'm sorry, we don't have you.
That's okay. I'll just can I get a hamburger?
Alright, happy to get that for you.
Thank you.
So number 7 is conversation. It's important to keep the conversation on track and to not get sidetracked. Going on tangents or talking about what you did last weekend at the wrong time, that's just not appropriate, so don't do that. Oh, you have a question?
Right, so I thought this was a luncheon, we could talk about whatever we want.
Well, it depends on the topic at hand, and if it's relating to, you know, whoever's leading the conversation, and it's about the business or about employees, you know, you want to keep on track. So, did anyone else have any other questions?
So tell me, how do you feel about it?
Why don't more people watch women's basketball? It's pretty
stay on topic.
Alright.
How you feel about working with Alright, Tommy, if you take a look right here, I'll show you the statistics about where we plan on going.
Well, I'll tell you later. Let's talk business for now.
Yeah, y'all can take a look at this too. If you take a look right here, this is where we plan on being.
Our last and final topic is number 8, the bill. So this is kind of a tricky one. Some business luncheons could be catered, you know, you don't even have to worry about it. I would especially advise if you're hosting the meeting to always, you know, make sure you pay or have some type of means of providing for people. And then if you're a guest, just always be like, hey, do I owe you anything for this meal? you know, ask politely, oh, do I owe anything, or I can take the bill for you if you have the means to do so. So just always be aware of that. Don't ever take anything for granted. Always be, you know, thankful of whoever is hosting and providing the food. Thank them for buying it. So keep that in mind as well.
All right, y'all, I think we're about to go ahead and wrap up this luncheon. So
here's the bill, guys.
Woo! Oh hell no! That's one for you.
Yeah, I got it.
That shit was like my dad.
All right, here's the bill, guys.
There it goes. I got it. I'm gonna pay for it.
Wait, should not. Let me.
Going to a business luncheon, and you're gonna do great. Good luck in your future endeavors.